SB Kevin Smith. This is the great Bear McCreary, ladies and gentlemen, the man responsible for the sound of Masters of the Universe, colon, Revelation. Sadly, when it comes to stuff like this, the last thought everyone has is, what's the score gonna be like? We got lucky because he loves Masters of the Universe. It was the silliest pitch meeting ever because he was pitching to people who had already pre-bought.
I knew you and I were gonna work well together when in 30 seconds, I was like, Metallica, Basil Poledouris is Conan the Barbarian.
As soon as you referenced Conan.
And you sang the love theme from Conan, and I was like, I'm gonna have to do this show now.
I'd been a Star Wars kid, collected all the toys, and when MOTU started, I was like, this is great, a new mythology. And it had a deep bench of interesting characters.
Yeah, and it wasn't like anything else on TV.
And you had one of those metal villains in all of cartoon history, like a dude with a skull for a face. And we got lucky enough one day, and as much as Netflix and Mattel Television said, we want to do kind of a sequel series that keeps everything together from the original show that everybody loves. Everybody looks the same, all the characters act the same, and then just tell a brand new story with it. And that's where Masters of the Universe Revelation came from. Our boss at Netflix, Teddy Biaselli, our exec there, he said the words, the watchwords, which have guided this entire project, which was treat it seriously. He goes, just treat it like Shakespeare. He goes, my whole life, I wish somebody would treat this stuff so seriously. So that was our manifest, let's treat it seriously. And eventually we handed over to somebody who's the first person outside the bubble who has to take it the rest of the way. You have to understand, music makes it, kids.
I'd never done an animated series before.
This is the first one?
My first animated series ever. I've only done live action series. So even that, I'm used to, like, okay, when I'm seeing a rough cut of yes. Walking Dead or Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., you're seeing everything's real.
Yes.
It's real.
And emotions on faces, which you can play.
Yes. Or you can ignore because it's real. Animation is, I almost found that it's like, I have to do more because it's almost like when there's no music, it's like, am I looking at drawings now?
Yes.
But then you the music like pulls you in to this world, and I was really struck by that. And I was thinking about, like, my favorite animated series is Batman the Animated Series.
Amazing.
One of the best scores
Brilliant score. Television
by Shirley Walker and her team. And I was thinking about that a lot, about, like, would I love that show as much if it didn't have that music?
No.
You know?
It just played so seriously, and that's what you did with this as well. It's so serious. And this, again, not to say there's not levity or lightness. I remember when he sent me a first piece of music, I was like, Bear, this, you should save this for like a motion picture. Like something that deserves something this deep and this serious. And your rationale was like, I'm just scoring what was there, man. He's like, you guys brought it, so I'm bringing it.
One was the biggest challenge of my career.
Because, why?
Here's why. Because it's actually the series finale of something else.
It is.
It's not the first episode, it's the last episode.
That is brilliant.
So here's the thing, in most first episodes,
yes.
It's like, here, I'm the hero, what's my theme? And I've met this beautiful girl, love theme, who's that? He's the bad guy theme. And then that's about it, right?
Yeah.
In your thing, it's like everybody comes crashing together immediately, and it's like they all have split second introductions, and I go, I gotta score Man-at-Arms, but it's not like an origin, he's just there.
Yeah.
So I gotta go, dun, 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 dun. Oh, Evil Inn shows up, and it's like, da, 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 da. Oh, Skeletor, it has to make sense on a second viewing for you to go, oh, that's everybody's theme. Orko, Sorceress, Adam, Teela, Grayskull has a theme, Battlecat, Beastman, to not only incorporate them all, but to write them all at the same time. It reminds me of a conversation we had early on, where I was wrapping my head around what you're doing. I'd read all the scripts and I'd seen the first few episodes, and I remember saying, like, here's what makes sense to me. Like, Skeletor and He-Man are like these, like suns, like gravity wells that do not move.
Right.
This guy is the devil, this guy is Superman. Like, I want a theme that is so unambiguous.
Yeah.
I want it to be like the centering force, and then everyone else orbits around them. And in those orbits, it's like they take on all these different emotions and we learn different things about them. I mean, Teela, we don't even hear her theme in 101 until she takes that crown off.
Yes, he's
She's
absolutely
kicking
right.
ass in the first fight. You know what theme is playing? Man-at-Arms
yeah.
theme.
Dun, 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 yeah, dun, 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 dun. Like, I won't stop.
Yeah.
I always like to create lyrics in my head. I won't stop. I'm Man-at-Arms.
Kevin, it's Man-at-Arms.
God damn it, I was close.
He is so cool. Like, I do this with all my themes, dude. Masters of the universe. There's a dude for real.
Like, that's the secret sauce, dude.
Skeletor is bad. Skeletor. Like, I do it all, man. Like, I hate to say this, that's what gets me in. Sometimes I'm just staring at the keyboard, just like, dude, I need the dumbest thing to get started.
That's
here.
It. So you sitting there going like, oh, Man-at-Arms, Man-at-Arms. He is so cool.
Oh,
like,
this is so embarrassing.
It makes sense.
Cut this part out.
This is the glory, though. This is the secret sauce. This is how people win awards and stuff like that.
Because I'm basically just playing with action figures.
Yes!
Like, I'm basically just like, yeah, like, I'm just doing that. And then I go, I want to put that into a piece of music that makes you feel that way.
Oh. One of the first things I think you went at was the transformation.
That was the first thing. I thought, if you hate this, I'm quitting the show.
I mean, it's a valid point. Like, I hadn't even thought about that. Yeah. But it is kind of like the centerpiece, right? He's got to transform. So when I heard the transformation piece, and it was like, oh, you know, I shot video of myself reacting to it and whatnot. Right then and there, I was like, oh my God, like that's the He-Man theme. That's the, whenever you see him, that's what you're gonna hear.
Remember
and you
that
hear it.
End credits of 101?
Oh my God, haunting, yeah. Haunting. Bear's already outdone himself with the score for episode one. The battle would destroy a normal man because it would be something saved for the end of the show. He had to do it up front and whatnot. But my God, the love that went into this decision alone. Rather than just let the end credit music be the same music over and over again, Bear decided to create a new piece of music for the end credits.
Many themes are debuted in the credits of the previous episode. And some of them, if you just put them back to back, same key, the same themes, it would just be continuous. Mm. It's just like, I thought of it as like a symphony, really. I thought of it as like a symphonic work where it's like, I want this all to be continuous and like respectful of not only the IP, but also the audience. Like, I want to reward you for taking the time to click and go, no, I want to hear those credits.
And again, he doesn't even have to do that. That's not part of the job. It's just that attention to detail that makes a thing so hard to put down once you've picked it up. When you feel the love that something was made with, that nobody was punching a clock or cashing a check here, people went above and beyond because they love a thing, because they're working on it the way they'd like to view it. You made the score that if you weren't working on this show, you'd be outraged if that wasn't it.
You know me so well.
It's perfect
true.
Score.
So I'm so grateful for the call and for you putting up with my bullheaded kind of like...
Nothing bullheaded about it. It's assurance. Yeah. Like, we go like, he clearly knows where we're going. Let's follow him. And that's, you know, you got to take any project from here to there. You've let us take it from here to Bear.